the young people that have raised their voice. I was the first leader to join the demonstration in Windhoek in Parliament when leaders were not finding it kind to come and support. I was one of the first leaders to stand at the prison cells when the young protesters were arrested until 1 a.m. in the night. I'm still here telling the leaders of this country, from all political divide, this is not an issue that should divide politicians. It's an issue that should unite this country. That our young people, our women, our children are in dire straits. Their bodies are being mutilated. They are being raped. They are being maimed. And we are too lax. When we moved a motion in Parliament before the demonstration started about sex offenders register, the ruling party's politicians were saying this matter should be parked in a committee. And we were saying leaders cannot park the issue of gender-based violence. We must be at the forefront. I want to do a call to all the leaders. We must do our work. We must do our work to bring, to make sure that we implement laws that protects and that creates deterrent measures for gender-based violence perpetrators. Because one of the things is that we have a law that says we must have a sex offenders register. For the last 7 years, this law has never been implemented. We must take action and make sure that we implement laws that will promote the survival of our children and women. I'm a father to girls. Today you think it's someone else's daughter. Tomorrow is yours. The life of Shannon Wasserfall matters, and it must be the last life that we should lose for against gender-based violence. We must rise up and give hope to our society. And I want to call on all leaders to join these demonstrations, because what these people are saying, they are saying the truth that will affect us tomorrow as fathers to women and girls in this country. Let's rise up, and I want to call to the gender, to the male gender group, that we are not protecting the weak in society. We are abusing our rights as fathers in this country. We must be ashamed of ourselves. We must rise up and support our young. We should rise up and support our women and our children in the name of brotherhood and sisterhood. And I want to call upon the men to really act in a dignified manner. Because what we are doing, we are not acting in a dignified manner. I want to call upon the church leaders, civil society, wherever there is masculinity, toxicity, we must rise up and make sure that we address it. In traditional authorities, in churches, in the soccer clubs, everywhere, we must address the issue of gender-based violence in this country. And that is why I'm demonstrating to be here together with the victims.
We are also cognizant and aware that we are approaching the election very soon. Is this perhaps a ploy for you to just come around?
You are insulting me. By saying that, you are insulting me, because I'm telling you I'm a father to girls. You are insulting me because it's not the first time that my party raised the issue of safe houses in this country for gender-based violence victims. I brought that motion. I brought the motion of sanitary pads when the ruling party was not eager to discuss sanitary pads in the hospital. We were the first party that brought safe houses. There's a sex offenders register before the marches. Don't insult us. We are fighting for the people of this country.
Thank you.
Country, when we say we need to shut it all down, addressed to the Honourable Minister of Justice, Honourable Yvonne Dowser, and it reads as follows: women in contemporary Namibia have become victims of rape, murder, torture, and unspeakable horror. It has become normal to read about cases where fathers rape daughters, babies, and defenceless children. We are gathered today with a deep sense of outrage against sexual and gender-based violence in Namibia. Men are the main perpetrators of all forms of violence and GBV in Namibia. However, many men do not think of gender-based violence as an issue that they are responsible for, nor an issue they have the responsibility to end. This often leaves the female children, child victims and survivors of GBV alone in standing up to eradicate it. This campaign makes a bold statement in challenging social accepted norms and behavior by publicly labeling unhealthy toxic masculinity and how they manifest in society as accepted acts of violence against women. The use of Keetmanshoop petition against gender-based violence in Namibia, gender-based violence is deeply rooted in gender inequality and continues to be one of the most notable human rights violations within all sectors of society. The current president, His Excellency Dr. Agigengob, needs to address the nation and declare that another pandemic is raging in our country. The killing of women and children by the men of our country, a powerful message that has been stated by women for years. Gender-based violence is present and consistent threat to women, yet our media, communities, and government responses do not consistently reflect this reality. The rates of gender-based violence, specifically violence against women at the hands of men in Namibia, has infiltrated all aspects of the daily life of a woman. It is present in the school, home, community, and public sector.